"If you are determined," said Athos, "do so."
"But the Bastille?" said Aramis.
"Bah! You will get me out if they put me there," said D'Artagnan.
"To be sure we will," replied
Aramis and Porthos, with admirable promptness and decision, as if that were the simplest thing in the world. "To be sure we will get you out. But meantime, as we are to set off the day after tomorrow, you would do much better not to risk this Bastille."
"Let us do better than that," said Athos. "Do not let us leave him during the whole evening. Let each of us wait at a gate of the palace with three musketeers behind him. If we see a close carriage, at all suspicious in appearance, come out, let us fall upon it. It is a long time since we have had a skirmish with the guards of Monsieur the Cardinal. Monsieur de Tréville must think us dead."
"To a certainty, Athos," said Aramis, "you were meant to be a general of the army. What do you think of the plan, gentlemen?"
"Admirable!" replied the young men in chorus.
"Well," said Porthos, "I will run to the hotel and engage our comrades to hold themselves in readiness by 8 o'clock. The rendezvous, the Place du Palais Cardinal. Meantime, you see that the lackeys saddle the horses."
"I have no horse," said D'Artagnan, "but that is of no consequence. I can take one of Monsieur de Tréville's."
"That is not worth while," said Aramis. "You can have one of mine."
"One of yours? How many have you, then?" asked D'Artagnan.
"Three," replied Aramis, smiling.
"Certes," cried Athos, "you are the best-mounted poet of France or Navarre."
"Well, my dear Aramis, you don't want three horses? I cannot comprehend what induced you to buy three.